Hi, my name is Fred Kohler, and I'm a member of the Solidworks training team. In this video, I'm going to show you some tips and tricks for selecting components in an assembly using a specialized set of selection tools. Let's look at some examples. I can select all of the components in the assembly using Select All or the keyboard shortcut Control A. We can select all instances of a component by clicking Select Identical Components and selecting one of the instances. I'll hide them. Hidden or suppressed components can be made visible using Select Hidden or Select Suppress. When they are visible, they can be selected to show or unsuppress them. I'll show all of these hidden components. I can use Volume Select to select with a 3D box. Starting with a 2D box selection, I can extend the faces of the box in space, selecting what's in the box. Select Internal Components selects components that are hidden inside of other components. Here the selection appears only in the Feature Manager Design Tree, but I can click Isolate to temporarily show only the selected components. Exit Isolate reverts back to nothing selected. As a more permanent option, if I use Select Internal Components again, I can select the unselected components using right-click Invert Selection and click to hide them. If I want to hide all the fasteners in the assembly, I can click Select Toolbox and hide them. To hide the physically smaller components, we can use Select by Size. Set a percentage of the overall assembly size, like 40% here. Select Mated To is used to select the components attached to a selected component rather than the component itself. I can use Select Flexible Subassembly to identify subassemblies that have been set to flexible. Select by View selects based on components that can be seen in a certain direction. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, click the link in the description below to access more great content.